tonight is the launch party for the Georgian Music issue of Oxford American Magazine, which is a celebration of all the great music and musicians from Georgia.
It's our 17th music issue and our 7th state series celebrating all things Georgia music.
We could not be more thrilled to be here. We've spent the last year really researching, exploring, discovering, and most of all listening to music from the state.
A hustler or white?
I think the biggest thing I've taken away from the project is just the immensity of the influence of Georgians on American music. There's really no corner of the state that hasn't touched American music. It's immense.
So yeah, you have all these different regions, and each of those regions had their historical song types and song forms and musical traditions. So you had, you know, like Art Rosenbaum played tonight, and he played a lot of the music from the mountains of Georgia.
When the winter winds begin to blow, you gotta miss your daddy so. Good gal, oh good gal.
And each of those regions really has its own kind of music, its own style of music. So it's like an amazing place for music.
Just to me, Georgia's the greatest music capital there is. And you look at Georgia, and some of the most under-recognized are Fletcher Henderson, Big Mama Thornton. And then you got Macon, my God, within 50 miles. You got Otis Redding, James Brown, Little Richard. I'm sorry, you can't beat that. No other state can beat that.
There's no other state in the nation that has the impact and influence that Georgia has had historically and that it continues to have. Georgia music has a global impact.
Well, I'm working on a push boat.
To have a prestigious literary magazine like Oxford American come along and curate this issue and tell these stories through different voices and different perspectives, I got to hear things I knew in a different way, and there's so many stories that I didn't know. So it's just a great thing for Georgia.